Good morning. My name is Michael Flier. I'm the director of the Ukrainian Research Institute here at Harvard, and I want to welcome you to the beginning of our international conference, The Great Famine in Ukraine, the Holodomor and Its Consequences, 1933 to the present. The conference, of course, is occasioned by the 75th anniversary of the Great Ukrainian Famine, one of the greatest human tragedies of our time. HURI, which is what we call the Institute, has a long history with the 1932-33 Holodomor. In 1982, it sponsored a research project for the 50th anniversary, and the names most closely associated with the project were Robert Conquest and James Mace. It's a matter of historiographical interest that Conquest was recommended for the job of writing a comprehensive overview of the Holodomor by the late Adam Ulam from our government department. Robert Conquest is senior research fellow and scholar curator of the East European Collection at the Hoover Institute at Stanford, and his magisterial 1968 study, The Great Terror, Stalin's Purges of the 30s, made him, of course, a prime candidate to do this. The major result was Conquest's scholarly treatment, Harvest of Sorrow, Soviet Collectivization and the Terror Famine, published by Oxford in 1986. And accomplished, I might add, without the help of Soviet archival material. James Mace was a recent doctorate from the University of Michigan who was recommended by his academic advisor, Roman Spolyuk, to do research and publications. There was a memorial exhibition in our Widener Library in 1984, and the publication of a related catalog, Famine in the Soviet Ukraine, 1932-33, that came out in 1986, compiled by Oksana Procik, Leonid Heretz, and James Mace. For the 70th anniversary of the Holodomor, HURI hosted a symposium entitled The Ukrainian Terror Famine of 1932-33, Revisiting the Issues in Scholarship 20 Years After the HURI Famine Project. Scholars from the United States, Italy, the Netherlands, and France presented their latest research into the causes, extent, and lasting impact of what the Special Commission on the Ukraine Famine in its 1988 report to the U.S. Congress called an act of genocide and terror. Organized by HURI Associate Director Dr. Lubomir Hajda, this symposium pursued a twofold purpose: to discuss some of the new findings in famine studies that had been achieved over the 20 years since the Harvard Ukrainian Research Institute launched its famine study project in 1982, and to map the course of future research. The 75th anniversary inspired the Institute once again to honor the memory of the Holodomor by hosting three major events in this anniversary year, 2007 and 2008. We hosted a two-day symposium on November 30th, December 1st last year, concerned with research on the Holodomor since the breakthrough represented in the publication of Conquest's book, and of course since the archives had been opened. The direct results of that conference, earlier published in Harvard Ukrainian Studies, has now been reprinted as a book, Hunger by Design, which is available from the Institute at a very modest price. Marika Whaley, our manager of publications, will be happy to provide you with a copy here at the conference, which we'll make her presence known later. The second major event, of course, is right now. In mid-November, we are hosting this international conference of the Holodomor, viewed as a historical event intrinsically and comparatively. What we are attempting to do is contextualize the Holodomor and consider its consequences, short-term, mid-term, and long-term. And then two related events. We are presenting excerpts from a new opera, Red Earth, Hunger, based on the Holodomor by Virko Ballet, tonight at 8 p.m. at the Swedenborg Chapel, which is right at the corner of Quincy Street and Kirkland Streets, just adjacent to the Institute itself. And then on Wednesday, December 3rd, at 7 p.m., a new documentary, Jivi, commemorating the 75th anniversary of Holodomor, co-sponsored by Columbia University Ukrainian Film Club, will be shown in the Tsai Auditorium of the CGIS South Building, Room 10. Now, a meeting of this scope is not organized overnight, but rather demands the hard work and energy of many people. And I want to take this time to, first of all, thank the entire staff at the Institute for all their hard work, and in particular, to single out Timish Holowinski, our executive director, Tamara Nadi, our programs coordinator, and Dr. Lubomir Haidar, our associate director. Now, this conference was co-organized by Dr. Haidar on our end and Professor Andrea Graziosi on the eastern side of the Atlantic. Professor Graziosi is an international specialist in Soviet and post-Soviet studies with special interest and expertise in archival sources. Since 1991, he has produced 13 books along with numerous articles, including 1996, The Great Soviet Peasant War, Bolsheviks and Peasants, 1917-33. In 2002, La Police Politique en Union Soviétique. In 2006, L'Unione Sovietica in 209 Citazioni. And in 2007, last year, L'URSS di Lenin e Stalin, Storia dell'Unione Sovietica, which, by the way, won two prizes, the Piemonte Storia Prize and the Capalbio Storia Politica Prize. In 2005, Professor Graziosi was the recipient of the Order of Yaroslav the Wise by decree from the President of Ukraine. He's held visiting appointments at Harvard, Yale, Moscow State University, École des Hautes Études en Sciences Sociales in Paris, and is currently Professor of Contemporary History, Università di Napoli Federico II, the President of the Italian Society for the Study of Contemporary History. Here to tell you about the conference and our plans for its smooth operation is Professor Andrea Graziosi.
Much publicity, as they say. So I'm sorry for all this publicity, but thank you. So I want to thank you, everybody, and the organizers and the staff at the Institute that were very helpful, because the conference was a lot of work. And to thank the Institute for putting this up. I know it's a great effort, even financially, not only so. But I think it's a very meaningful event. I think we have here the best scholars on the famine. I'm very grateful that you accepted to come for this conference. And when I will just say very few words, and of course we meet in a scientific spirit. This goes without saying. That is, we will discuss scientifically new questions, I hope. When we decided, when we discussed, just to explain in a very few words the spirit of the conference, what could be done? I think we had two options. Scientifically, because we can say proudly, I don't speak for myself, there are here people that contributed much more than I did to the study of the famine, but we can proudly say that over the past 20 years, 15 years, let's say, 20 years, since Conquest published this book, we have now a coherent, very believable picture of what happened. Very coherent, very believable. I think, you know, there are a few people here and there that still do not accept it, but they are very few, and I think they are so wrong, they will accept it nonetheless very soon. That is, and the growing consensus on what happened is the proof of this progress of science, let me say so. Sometimes this happens. It's strange, but sometimes it does happen. So I think we had two options. One was to produce something new. One was an interpretive conference. That is, now that we know what happened, how to interpret this? And this meant, of course, not only the genocide question, that is a very alive question, as you know, politically, but from a scientific point of view, to compare the Holodomor to other events. Because what we learned over the years after 1991 is that There are in European history, just because that's what I know more or less, only in European history there are several cases that could be rightly considered genocide. Several. Much more than I thought. And of course this raises a huge question of what a genocide is, because we have only a legal definition and a general definition that was thought of when this was not known in great detail. So actually, we have more of a legal category than an historical interpretive category. So we could have done, you know, a real discussion of interpretive question that would have been important. But let me tell you that, first of all, this would have meant convening people studying many different things. And I Neither I nor other people have the competence and the knowledge and the personal contacts in order, you know, needed to organize such a conference. And also, we thought instead that another great topic was to look at what happened after the Holodomor. That is the consequences of the Holodomor, that this has never been studied. And here, too, I think we could give, actually contribute, not only to Ukrainian history, but generally to European history, because the more we know, this I just said, the more we know about European history, let's say, from the end of the 19th century, the great Armenian massacres of the 1890s, through the beginning of the 1950s, let's say, to Stalin's death, the more we know, the more we see traumas of great magnitude. Different, of course, but all of them of a very great magnitude. So the problem of this, one could call it, at the beginning I said this as a joke, of studying post-trauma, what happened after these traumas happened, historically, not as political debate. I think it's of a great importance to understand the history of each country and each people that went through this. But in order to do this, of course, we have, and this was the idea behind the conference, you have to look at the consequences at different, let's say, time level and spans, and also at different temporal, social, national, demographic, mentality levels. And to study the impact that on this great tragedy had other tragedies, the war, the post-war famine, the life under the last years of Stalin, and then the urbanization under Khrushchev and Brezhnev. That is to study how the society, the demography, the mentalities change, the ideology changed and evolved over time, starting from this great tragedy. So and with this I finish. The idea of study what happened after, I think, is a key concept, not just for Ukrainian history, but for all European history. And I will just finish with this. Even in Italy, which after all, if I am allowed to say a word about my country, that after all went through a very minor trauma compared to others, the mentality and the politics is completely still fixed and focused upon those crucial years. And this is 60 years afterwards. In a way, the incapacity to look at what happened, in my opinion, the inability to look at what happened after, it's also weighing very heavily on our capacity to see the future, because we are still have our eyes focused on that. So my hope is that a scientific discussion of the impact, the consequences, the developments after the famine will help also the political general debate that the intellectual debate in each country to forget, but to acquire the capacity to look to the future in a different way, in a freer way. So I thank you again, everybody, for coming. And I just add a final line. Professor Flier was so nice. He said all those good things about me, but in the booklet you received there is a lie. I never received a doctorate from the Sorbonne. I want to be very specific. So please, I do not claim it. It was a minor misunderstanding of another title. French titles are very complicated. So I'm not a swindler. Please believe me. I don't have this title. Thank you very much, and I hope the conference to be a success. Thank you again.
So I guess we'll tear up that letter of inquiry to Paris. We won't need to follow it up. It's my pleasure to welcome the Consul General of Ukraine, Mykola Kyrychenko, to say a few words of greeting before our conference begins.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. Dear participants of the conference, honorable guests, ladies and gentlemen, presently, Ukraine begins to commemorate 75th anniversary of Holodomor 1932-33. Great famine is one of the most worst humanitarian catastrophes in the history of mankind. In consequence of deliberate and accurately planned policy of totalitarian communist regime, millions of Ukrainians were massacred. on its terrible scale of human losses. Holodomor outnumbered even our nation's losses during World War II. We are still facing consequences of this merciless terror aimed at systematic extermination of Ukrainian nation. These acts of totalitarian regime demand international condemnation. Ukrainian diplomatic corps, as well as Ukrainians abroad, have made significant efforts to bring international community to recognition of Holodomor as genocide against Ukrainian nation. These efforts should continue emphatically and consistently in order to bring into the light before the world the truth about these past times of distress. On the 22nd of November, the President of Ukraine is convening a high-level international forum in Kyiv to raise awareness of the tragic events of 1932-33. A new memorial complex in the capital will be inaugurated on that day. This very same day, light the candle ceremony will take place in every corner of the world where Ukrainians live. Let me assure you that the government of Ukraine will not tire in its efforts to seek international recognition of the Ukrainian famine genocide. We have ensured adoption of the relevant resolutions and statements in UNESCO, OSCE, European Parliament, Council of Europe. We shall continue our work in the UN Council on Human Rights and the UN General Assembly. I truly hope that this conference will contribute substantially to this goal, and let me wish all success to the conference. Thank you very much for your attention.